Is this the end of architects? This convention center in Shanghai was designed by an algorithm, but the final decisions were still made by humans. In this video, we'll break down how AI actually shaped the West Bund Convention Center, what architects gave up, what they kept, and why this project quietly changes how buildings will be designed in the future. Before we run the algorithm of this story, make sure to optimize your feed and subscribe to Design Zip. When the firm Skidmore, Owings & Merrill, also known as SOM, was asked to design a permanent home for a major AI convention, they decided the West Bund Convention Center itself should be a product of the technology it hosted. Instead of starting with a sketch, they started with rules. They locked in the non-negotiables, the site size, the floor area, and the room heights. Then, they handed the creative freedom over to an algorithm. The architects set six core objectives for the AI. 1. Creating the most floor space. 2. Balancing how enclosed or open the spaces feel. 3. Deciding how large each space should be and how they connect. 4. Coordinating facade panel sizes with the building's structural frame. 5. Maximizing sunlight. 6. Improving views for occupants. Here's the catch. In architecture, these goals usually fight each other. For example, chasing more sunlight usually means giving up floor space or rethinking where views are possible. The AI ran thousands of simulations overnight, balancing these trade-offs at a speed no human could match. When the architects came into the office the next morning, they weren't looking at one sketch. They were looking at 800 different versions of the building, and that number could have gone much higher. With more time, the system could have produced thousands, even millions of variations. This is where the role of the architect changed. Instead of searching for ideas, the team evaluated results. They reviewed the strongest performers and compared them side by side. Numbers guided the process, but they didn't make the final call. The architects selected the option that felt the most elegant and confident in its setting. That choice couldn't be automated. As design partner Scott Duncan put it, the algorithm doesn't understand beauty. It can calculate outcomes. It can balance trade-offs. But it doesn't know what feels right. That judgment stayed human. The result is a facade where nothing is random. Every angle of that glass is mathematically placed to optimize light and performance. This unique design creates depth and movement without decoration. In daylight, the building reflects light like metal. At night, it absorbs it and turns almost black. That visual tension is intentional. It's faster architecture. SOM estimates this saved weeks of research and allowed them to test the building's carbon footprint and energy performance before a single brick was laid. Now that we understand how this building was designed, the next part of the story matters just as much: where it was built and why that location makes all the difference. This building sits along the Huangpu River, inside Shanghai's West Bund, and this location was chosen on purpose. West Bund runs through Shanghai's Zhuhui district and stretches across an 11.4-kilometer waterfront, covering about 9.4 square kilometers of land. Today, it looks open and carefully planned. But for most of the last century, this area had a very different role. West Bund used to be a heavy industrial zone. There were rail yards, factories, cement plants, and port equipment. It was built for production, not for people. Access to the river was limited, and public life stayed away from the edge. That changed when Shanghai began thinking long-term about what kind of global city it wanted to become. Under the Shanghai 2035 Master Plan, West Bund was labelled a high-quality central activity zone, or CAS. In simple terms, this meant the district was expected to carry the core functions of a world city in one place. These core functions are culture, innovation, business, and public life. The first big move was reclaiming the riverfront. Instead of hiding industry behind walls, planners turned the Huangpu into the backbone of the district. The result is an 8.4-kilometer cultural corridor that runs directly along the water. More than 20 major cultural and art institutions now line this stretch, including well-known museums and exhibition spaces. On busy summer evenings, the Riverside Park can draw up to 20,000 people. What was once a rust belt has turned into one of the city's most active public spaces. At the same time, West Bund was positioned as a technology centre. The district openly brands itself around what it calls the AA engine, meaning art and AI. That pairing is intentional. Shanghai didn't want a cold tech zone cut off from the city. It wanted a place where culture, creativity, and advanced technology overlap. This is why West Bund already includes landmarks like the AI Tower, and why a massive 13 million square foot AI Valley is planned here. That AI Valley is expected to host technology companies worth a combined $14 billion, making this area one of the most concentrated AI zones in the country. Once you see this bigger picture, the convention center's location makes sense. An AI-assisted building wouldn't mean much if it sat in isolation. Here, it becomes part of a larger system. Museums on one side, tech campuses on the other, public space flowing between them. Large developments around the site push that idea even further. Projects like West Bund Central, one of the biggest mixed-use developments currently underway in Asia, cover about 1.8 million square meters. Offices, hotels, retail housing, and cultural venues are all being built together, with completion expected around 2028. Zoom out again, and West Bund fits into Shanghai's wider regeneration strategy. The city holds more than 20 million square meters of historic buildings, and has committed to renewal without erasing identity. The Huangpu River links multiple districts, and Shanghai is even constructing 27 tunnels beneath it to make sure the river connects the city rather than divides it. All of this turns West Bund into a testing ground. New planning ideas land here first. New design methods get real-world pressure here. That's why an AI-driven design experiment belonged here. And this is where the story moves beyond one building. What the West Bund Convention Center really shows is a shift in how architecture is starting to work. Is this the end of the traditional architect? Not quite, but it is a shift. Right now, most architects are still cautious about AI. Surveys back that up. Nearly 70% of architects say they feel optimistic about AI, and around half have tried it in some form. But when you look at actual daily use, only about 6% rely on it regularly. In the UK, the picture is similar, with 59% of firms saying they never use AI at all. That gap between interest and adoption exists for a reason. Architecture carries real risk. Buildings cost millions. They last decades. Mistakes don't disappear. Many architects worry about inaccuracies, unintended results, and losing control of the design process. Almost 90% of surveyed architects point to those exact fears. Others worry about originality, job security, and bias hidden inside training data. There is also a deeper issue. Architecture lives between science and art. On the science side, AI feels useful. It can calculate daylight, structure, energy, and efficiency faster than any person. On the art side, people get uncomfortable. Creativity feels personal. Authorship matters. That's why AI-generated art creates tension instead of excitement. This building sits right in the middle of that debate. What it proves is that AI doesn't need to replace designers to matter. In this project, AI expanded the field of options. It handled trade-offs. It tested hundreds of solutions that would never fit into a traditional timeline. But it didn't decide what the building should be. Humans still made that call. That's the real change. Architects move from guessing to judging. Instead of drawing a few ideas and hoping they work, they can review hundreds of tested outcomes. Performance comes first. Aesthetics still matter. They just come later. SOM didn't stop with this project. After completing the building, the firm launched its own internal AI tool called Natalie. This tool can help with tasks like facade shading and floor planning. That detail is important. It shows this wasn't a one-time experiment. It became part of the workflow. And at the scale of West Bund, this kind of approach becomes even more valuable. Districts with millions of square meters, strict sustainability targets, and complex public spaces need tools that reduce guesswork early. So this is not AI architecture, it is faster architecture, better tested architecture, architecture with fewer blind spots. The West Bund Convention Center shows what happens when architecture stops guessing and starts testing. An algorithm explored thousands of possibilities, but it was still human judgment that decided what felt right, what belonged on the river, and what deserved to be built. For me, that's not a loss for architects. It's a correction. AI doesn't replace design thinking, but it does strip away uncertainty early and forces architects to be clearer about the choices that truly matter. So the real question is this: if a building performs better, wastes less, and is more carefully tested, does it matter whether the first idea came from a human mind or a machine? I'd be curious to hear where you draw that line. If you're interested in how architecture, design, and construction are changing at a global scale, this is exactly what we explore here on DesignZip. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.